I've always wanted to be the very best, like no one ever was. The ACT was my real test, and getting into an elite college was my cause. In order to obtain that future, I did a lot in high school. I think it's actually an understatement to say I was in a lot of clubs. I've been blessed to have so many different opportunities at MHS. And while I'm pretty proud of a lot of the things I did in this high school, the thing I'm proudest of is seeing how everyone around me evolved into the amazing class that's here today. I came from Hawthorne, so I knew about 10 kids before I came to this school. It would have been really lonely if I didn't know my twin brother any since the womb. But over the past 4 years, I've come to know a lot of the kids here. I definitely know some more than others, but I know that the class as a whole is enough. I know that we're going to do great things. But more importantly, we're all good, hardworking people, and that's why we want to do great things. Nothing's ever been handed to us on the silver platter. We work for everything that we have. This has made us all more responsible, more versatile, more persistent. While some people will back off, we challenge adversity head on. You need a lot of experience in life in order to move forward and level up, and you can only earn that experience by overcoming obstacles. To quote Rocky Balboa, it's not about how hard you hit, it's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. It's about how much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. I've certainly had my fair share of obstacles in life, and the biggest one was losing my dad in 8th grade. That wound will never heal. And there's not a day that goes by that I don't think about my dad. But as cliche as it sounds, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. I took my dad's death and made it into my motivation. Everything I did after April 24, 2013 was